Hey folks, John Ferguson Smart here. How should you write your given when then scenarios? Should they be long and detailed and tell people exactly what they need to do to test at each step? Should they describe the detailed interactions so that the tester can look at those tests and just know exactly how they would run that test? Or should they be more declarative and describe the business goals and the business outcomes and the problem that the customer is trying to achieve or the task the user is trying to complete and what outcomes they expect? It's a big difference. But the thing is, it comes from two different worlds, two different ways of thinking. And the differences, the impact that those two approaches have are huge. What I mean by that is that if you go and do what we call an imperative test script, where you have each click, each select, each action in great detail, you end up with a very long test script effectively. That's great if you want to give that test script to another person and have them, without any knowledge of the application, perform that test. But test automation is not about that. If you apply that thinking to test automation, then what will happen is you'll have a lot of very long and detailed scripts that become extremely hard to maintain and also extremely hard to understand. Because what you need to remember when you're writing these cucumber acceptance criteria, these gherkin scenarios, is that gherkin scenarios are not about writing test scripts. They are about describing business rules so that you can come back to them later on and understand what you're actually trying to implement. And once you understand that, you realize that when you write a long detailed approach, it seems like what is happening is you're getting a lot more detail, you're getting a lot more precision, but in reality, you're covering one thread of the application, one way of testing a particular flow. Whereas the business rules might have lots of little variations at different stages. So imagine you have a script, for example, where you say, given I enter $20 in the invoice field and I click on the button, what happens if it's a different value? What happens if you click on a different button? What happens if there are different options? How do the business rules affect them? So when you write a very long, detailed, prescriptive test script to style gherkin, you miss out on all of that. Gherkin is about describing business rules, not about describing test scripts. Once you sort of capture that idea, once you understand that, then things become a lot easier and your test scripts, your scenarios, become much easier to maintain. That's all for today, folks. Thanks for listening.